We thank you for giving them to us, to know and to love as companions on our earthly pilgrimage. In your boundless compassion, console us who mourn. Give us faith to see in death the gate of eternal life, so that in quiet confidence we may continue our course on earth until by your call we are reunited with those who have gone before. Through Jesus Christ our Lord.
Amen.
A reading from the Book of Wisdom. But the souls of the righteous are in the hand of God, and no torment will ever touch them. In the eyes of the foolish, they seemed to have died, and their departure was thought to be a disaster, and their going from us to be their destruction. But they are at peace. For though in the sight of others they were punished, their hope is in full of mortality, immortality. Having been disciplined a little, they will receive great good, because God tested them and found them worthy of himself. Like gold in the furnace, he tried them, and like a sacrificial burnt offering, he accepted them. In the time of their visitation, they will shine forth and will run like sparks through the stubble. They will govern nations and rule over peoples, and the Lord will reign over them forever. Those who trust in him will understand truth, and the faithful will abide with him in love, because grace and mercy are upon his holy ones, and he watches over his elect. Hear what the Spirit is saying to God's people.
Thank you.
rose again. Even so, through Jesus, God will bring with him those who have died. For the Lord himself was a cry of command with the archangel's call and with the sound of God's trumpet, who descend from heaven, and the dead in Christ will rise first. Then we who are alive, who are left, will not be caught up in the clouds together with those to meet the Lord in the air, and we so will be with the Lord forever. Therefore, encourage one another with these words. Hear what the Spirit is saying to God's people.
Thanks be to God. Bible Church.
ready with an answer. So the excuses are part of the routine now. How have I fallen into sin? Who will bring the casseroles when I have a baby? What I feel these days is not guilt, but something more nefarious, dull resignation. Do I want a church that fits me, or a me that fits the church? God makes sense to me under the trees, and God makes sense to me in poetry and prayer, and God makes sense to me in Eucharist and baptism and community and even creeds. Gentle, quiet, am I selfish for wanting more? And who will bring the casseroles when I have a baby? We come to church not just to celebrate resurrection, but the wholeness of our lives. And we come to be in community because some days our faith is strong and sometimes it's not even a whisper. I invite you to sit up in your seats, plant both feet on the floor, and if you're standing, you can plant your feet still. And to take a deep breath. And inhale and exhale. And on your next inhale, to raise your arms up. We greet God the Creator. And to reach your arms out to those nearby. We greet God the Sanctifier of one another. And to bring your arms, your hands to your hearts. We bless God the Spirit. We come together in community to say it's okay to not be okay. It's okay to not have the answers. And also to show up for one another. To hold not just in here, but out here, together. And so, as we honor our loved ones who we see no longer, we also honor that we hold one another up in community, in Christ, in the whole dance of the Trinity. Amen.
Lord of light, you have made us in your image to reflect your truth and light. We give you thanks for all we remember today, for the grace and mercy they received from you, for all that was good in their lives, for the memories we treasure today. We especially remember Boy Aubrey, Betty Bogart, Johnson Bogart, Karen Rowland, Bob Bonino, Mark Oshart, Craig Costas, Colonel Ernest and Sylvia Elliott, H.B. Gellott, Roy Hansen, Diana Hardesty, Chuck Johnson, Walt Marcus, Caroline Ducky Merrill, Nancy McCormick, Bonnie Elizabeth Merrick, Raymond Manoa, Charlotte Murdoff, Al and Kitty Newman, Caroline Searing Newman, Evelyn Lofton, Dan Power, Dorothy Power, Liz Thwing, Bill Tinkin, Dylan Toma, Brian Toth, Anna Marie Del Valle, Eric Volgris, and Al Ward, and all those others want to remember. I invite your prayers for all of those and those you wish to remember. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
You promised eternal life to those who believe. Remember for good your servants as we remember them this day. Bring all who rest in Christ into the fullness of your kingdom, where sin has been forgiven and death is no more. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
Your will is none should be lost. Gather into your graceful arms those who did not believe, and those whose faith is known to you alone, that they may know your peace and life. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
Your mighty power brings joy out of grief and life out of death. Lord, in mercy, look in mercy on all who mourn. Give them patient faith in times of darkness. Strengthen them with the knowledge of your love. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
You are tender towards your children, and your mercy is over all your works. Heal memories of hurt and failure. Give us the wisdom and grace to use right the time that is left to us here on earth, to turn to Christ and follow in his steps in the way that leads to everlasting life. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
Your will is that of reconciliation for all peoples. As we remember veterans this week, we remember for good all those who have died in the service of their country. Lord, in your mercy,
hear our prayer.
God of mercy, entrusting into your hands all that you have made and rejoicing in our communion with all your faithful people, we make our prayers through Jesus Christ, our Savior.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be always with you.
And also with you.
Thank you. morning, all. It was just a month ago when I stood before you and announced the process of the vestry would be using to select our candidates. And here we are a month later, and it's my honor to introduce our search committee for the next permanent rector of St. Paul's. Some of whom, due to illness, cannot be with us today, but we are blessing and commissioning them in absentia. So let me introduce Charles Warden and Jill Cleary are our co-chairs, Michelle Beauchart, Ann Cassells, Tim Elliott, Edith Boothrath, James Earle, Jenny Lau, Tom Power, and Rue Ritchie.
The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Let us pray. O eternal God, the foundation of all wisdom and the source of all courage, enlighten with your grace the search committee of this congregation, and so rule their minds and open their eyes and hearts, and guide their counsels that in all things they may seek your glory and place before the vestry the priest called by God and this committee to serve as rector to the people of St. Paul's through Jesus Christ our Lord. Amen.
Amen.
In the name of God and this congregation, I commission you to this ministry as members of the search committee of St. Paul's. May the Holy Spirit burn brightly in your heart and lead you all to truth in this work through Jesus Christ, our Lord, who lives and reigns in one God forever and ever. Amen.
Amen.
Let us with gladness present the offerings and oblations of our, before we do that with gladness, we do have the roses which will be handed out after you receive communion at both sides. You are welcome to keep those with you, or if you would like, you can take them to the table by the font after communion, so either is fine. Now, let us with gladness present the offerings and oblations of our life and labor to God.
Thank you.
page 5 of the bulletin. The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right to give God thanks and praise.
God of all power, ruler of the universe, you are worthy of glory and praise.
Glory to you forever and ever.
At your command, all things came to be, the vast expanse of interstellar space, galaxies, suns, the planets in their courses, and this fragile earth, our island home. From the primal elements, you brought forth the human race and blessed us with memory, reason, and skill. You made us the rulers of creation, but we turned against you and betrayed your trust, and we turned against one another. Again and again, you called us to return. Through prophets and sages, you revealed your righteous law. And in the fullness of time, you sent your only son, born of a woman, to fulfill your law, to open for us the way of freedom and peace.
By his blood, he reconciled us. By his Holy Spirit, he.
And therefore we praise you, joining our with the heavenly chorus, with prophets, apostles, martyrs, and with all those in every generation who have looked to you in hope, to proclaim with them your glory in their unending hymn.
Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come.
God, which passes all understanding, keep your hearts and minds in the knowledge and love of God, and of his Son, Jesus Christ, our Lord. The blessing of God Almighty, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit be upon you and remain with you now and always.